Well, I think you can change. Let me give you a quick story. Frank knows, of course, he was there with me, and he was at Dr. Bullitt's office at the Bethesda Neighbor Hospital. She was showing us the slides. We saw the thing in acupuncture, 1826. What's that? So from there, I went on a research and found out that what that slide meant, 1826 acupuncture. Acupuncture actually has a really, something you can tell us much about, this has a connection with the founding fathers of this country. The first recorded acupuncture study in this country was done in 1823-26 by Franklin Beach, who was Benjamin Franklin's grandson. And if you go back to the 1840s, 1850s, 1860s, you'll see the surgical medical journals of COVID acupuncture. And the United States was the first to perform electrical acupuncture in the world.
And it was Atlanta. John, it was at Lancaster Hospital Penitentiary for inmates for arthrosis, I think they called it, and also for another issue. Yeah, exactly. Well, I have to wonder how that study would hold up today. I wonder how that study would hold up today. But it brings up this issue of research, which Dr. Paul Raffer is going to talk about in about half an hour. Can you say more about your relationship to Dr. Nimzow and how your position there came about through the battlefield acupuncture training?
Sure. My position with Dr. Nimzow there, I did a 5-year fellowship at Andrews Air Force Base. I got to follow around to other naval hospitals, Walter Reed, Bill Private Practice, and even around the country to watch him talk and teach. And from that point, I watched him for 5 years, up front personal, real close, on what he does. And I got a real in-depth understanding
of what he's doing. Say more about what you saw and what he does. When you say what you got to see up close, so what he does, talk about that a little.
Okay. One of the things he's known for is called the battlefield acupuncture. What that is using AFP ear needles, and this is a little part, that are placed in your ear, and patients walk. The pain will basically disappear just over a course of minutes. I got to watch him firsthand do that for a number of years. And along with those protocols, I watched him do the xerostomia treatment, which he came up with. He's also a radiation oncologist by training, and he saw a lot of cancer patients. So I got to watch him do these protocols, refine these protocols, and even helped him kind of understand probably a little bit from a traditional Chinese point of view. I don't know if he understood anything I was saying, but I was able to just get right next to him and really see how he processed his thoughts, how he looked at things. And it was a really eye-opening experience for me because I got firsthand knowledge of not, oh, this point works for this. But he taught me really how to think and how to approach something that I didn't have before. It was a great skill. And for that, I really thank him. And even to today, I still go and watch him. Not as frequently, maybe every month or so, every 2 months maybe, have dinner with them and stuff like that. We always talk acupuncture. So I got a really good understanding of the microsystem of ear and hand, not so much a scalp, but ear and hand, and just to watch acupuncture be brought into the military fray. Myself as a combat medic, where I was fighting wars, there were two drugs we had. If something happened, you had 14. But if there was a head wound and the patient had a low respiratory rate, that was, you couldn't use it. And then the other thing I got to give was Motrin. So there was nothing in between. So who knows now?
Well,